Because the ESP32-P4 includes native CSI camera support, it enables more efficient and flexible camera applications. I've been developing several projects based on this feature, and this project is one of them. In this project, I connected an OV5647 camera and two servo motors to the ESP32-P4 with a 7-inch screen. The setup shows live video from the camera right on the screen, and I added two sliders that let you move the camera up and down, left and right using the servos. It's all powered by two 18650 batteries, so you can take it anywhere and use it. You can build better systems with SBCs like the Raspberry Pi, and believe it or not, I'm building some of those myself. But microcontroller-based projects are always more fun. It's more challenging. The ESP32-P4 used here is a Waveshare product with 32 MB of flash memory and PSRAM. It's nearly identical to Expressive's ESP32-P4 function EB board, differing only in memory size and the presence of an Ethernet port. It's all the same other than that. I used the PCA9685 to control the two servo motors of I2C, sorry, I2C. It's a pretty common chip, so I'm sure most of you have seen it before. As for the camera, I went with the OV5647. Honestly, this thing's total zombie. I think it came out around 2010, but you can still find it for like $7 from Amazon. For that price, it's still a really solid camera module. This is the power supply. You just press this button to turn it on, and if there is no power draw for a while, it automatically shuts off. It's basically a little self-managing power system. The screen interface is built with LVGL, and I added sliders to control the motor movement. This setup's actually meant to be directional, not for 360 coverage. It's usually mounted a bit higher up, pointing down toward the target. The camera can move about 120 degrees vertically and around 180 degrees horizontally. Depending on how you mount the motors and what you're using it for, you could definitely tweak it for even better coverage. Let me show you the inside of the housing shell. As you can see, there's honestly not much going on in here, just the PCA9685 board and the servo motor. The setup's super simple, both the PCA9685 and the ESP32-P4 run off the same battery. Nothing fancy inside, just the basics doing the job. Here's the OV5647 camera. I'm using the M12 interchangeable lens version, which makes it easy to swap out lenses later for field of view testing. It costs a bit more than the basic $7 version, but it's still super affordable for something with interchangeable lenses. As you can see, this is a very simple local camera controller. The only issue I have for now is the FPS is displayed in the top left corner of the screen, and it's outputting around 25 FPS. When I test the OV5647 before, it's over 35 FPS. There must be some bottleneck in my code that's preventing it from getting over 30 FPS. I will try to find the root cause and upgrade the entire system. Besides that, simply controlling the servo motors and viewing the live image on the screen is fun. As I mentioned earlier, I believe using the ESP32-P4's CSI camera will enable more powerful application development. For example, if you were to build a project that captures images from the ESP32-P4 and sends them to a local or remote server connected via ESP32-C6 Wi-Fi without a display, you could build a faster camera system. Let's see how it goes. Okay. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.